You look like Jesus. You look like Jesus. Grab your seats, everybody. Touch somebody beside you. Tell that person God will speak to you today. We've got some people from Feast Houston. Are you here? Can you raise your hand? You, alone. All right. Just want to welcome you. That's wonderful. Give our greetings. God made us in his image and likeness. Maybe it'll be better if you say it in Tagalog. Tap somebody beside you and say, Kamukha mo si Lord. You know, somebody sent me a mystery. It says here, it's in Tagalog. Kung galit tayo sa unggoy, bakit may mukhang kabayo? Can you tell somebody beside you, hindi mo kamukha ang unggoy? Hindi mo kamukha ang kabayo? Kamukha ka ni Lord. You know, when you read that passage we just read a while ago, it's powerful. We're made in this image, and then, you know, if you go through the Bible, I just you get this very tense relationship between man and animals. And God asked us to rule. Everybody say rule. It says here, so that they may rule over the fish and the sea and the birds in the sky and over the livestock and all the wild animals and over all the creatures that move along the ground. One more time, everybody say rule. But the word rule here, that man is supposed to rule the animals, is one of benevolent ruling. It is to rule, not to molest or to maltreat or to manipulate, but to rule with magnanimity. Spell magnanimity. Rule with love. And that's why this so fits St. Francis of Assisi. Do you know the guy? St. Francis of Assisi, when he sees a dog, he called it brother dog. When he sees a cat, he says sister cat. This I don't like. When he sees a rat, he says brother rat. Ugh. But that's St. Francis. I put the limit there. If I see a cockroach, I will not call him brother roach. I will not. I'm still spiritually immature. I will squash those crawling things in Jesus' name. You know. But that's Francis. And if you read the scripture, you find it here, even in the temptation of Jesus. Let's go over there, all the way to the New Testament. Mark 1, verse 13. And Jesus was in the wilderness for 40 days from being tempted by Satan. And he was with, I didn't get this, I just kind of like glanced through it, skipped through it, didn't really bother to look at it, but it's there. And Jesus was with the, what? Wild beast. Whoa. Everybody say harmony. If men are supposed to rule the animals with benevolence, with generosity, with magnanimity, then there will be harmony. In fact, if you go all the way to the book of Isaiah, we're going to go to a lot of scripture passages today. Isaiah 11, verse 6 and 7, it says here that the new creation, everybody say new creation, read this. The wolf will live with a lamb. The leopard will lie down with a goat. These animals eat each other, right? No. Here in the new creation, the calf and the lion and the yearling together, and a little child will lead them. Everybody say it. A little child will lead them. The cow will feed with a bear. The young will lie down together, and the lion will eat straw like the ox. The lion will become a vegetarian. Amazing. The infant will play near the cobra's den. Mommy, here's my bed, cobra. And the young child will put his hand into the viper's nest. I love it when it says, and the little child will lead them. A time will come when he people would want to be led. The rulers today, they use force, and they use threats, and they use intimidation, and they use fear. A time will come when people will be led by a child, humble and innocent and loving. No need for anger, no need for threats, because they would want to be led. You know, this is so close to my heart, because all of us here in the light of Jesus, we began in 1980. I was 14 years old, and my dad and mom, they were the real founders of the community. But from day one, my mom and my dad looked at me as a 14-year-old boy and said, "You lead the community." And so no matter what I'm doing, I was obedient and said, "Okay." But really, it's just, why would those people, we were 30 only at that time, but why would they follow a 14-year-old kid? And some of them were married, some of them had jobs, and I believe it was perfecting. You know, they had amazing humility and maturity. This whole testing, tense relationship between man and beast, man and animal, it came here when, think about how sin entered humankind. Genesis chapter 3 verse 1, Adam and Eve fell, but who tempted them? Who seduced them? Genesis 3 verse 1, now the serpent, everybody say serpent, was more crafty than the other beasts of the field that the Lord God had made. Story, Adam and Eve, they were supposed to rule the animals, yes or no? But here, in this particular story, the serpent was allowed to rule Eve. And you get this idea that instead of ruling over the animal, Eve allowed the animal to rule over her. Are you listening to what I'm saying? And because of that, what happens a few years later? Cain and Abel were the children of Adam and Eve. The symbolic story of Adam and Eve. You know, you've got Cain and Abel. And what happens? Ask me what happens. Genesis chapter 4, verse 6 to 7. That the Lord said to Cain, "Why are you angry? Why is your face downcast? If you do what is right, will you not be accepted? But if you do not do what is right, sin is crouching at your door. It desires to have you. But you must what? Rule over it." The word crouching is such a symbol of what's happening here. Who crouches? You know, my son and I, he was doing a Bible study on this, and I was just listening to him, and I was saying, yes, this is exactly what I want to preach. This is amazing. So what crouches? What crouches? A serpent. And here, listen, it says, but you must rule over it. But did Cain rule over the animal? Did Cain rule over the animal instinct? You know the story. What did he do? Chapter 4, verse 8. Now Cain said to his brother Abel, "Let's go out into the field." While they were in the field, Cain attacked his brother Abel and killed him. Who ruled what? The animal ruled. While they were in the field, who attacks in the field? Who attacks in the common grass? The serpent. What am I saying? I'm saying that we're made in the image and likeness of God. How many of you believe that again? Hey, put your hand over your chest and say, "I'm supposed to look like Jesus." Really, we're made by God. We're supposed to act like God. But now, here in the story, God is acting like beasts. Are you with me on this? Which is sad. Which is sad. killed man and woman and child. He has killed babies. And he said, I was instructed, we were instructed to kill everyone. Because babies will also become soldiers one day. And they will fight us. And they will kill us. So we will kill them now. You know what? I realized this. In war, there are no winners. Yes or no? Winners and losers? We're all losers. Ask me why. I've got a word for you. Men are not supposed to be adulterous. Do you know who is promiscuous? Ask me what. Dogs. Am I right? Have you seen a dog during heat? It does it with anyone or with anything. As long as a dog, if there's an available dog, whatever dog, you know, myself here. Please don't misunderstand me. I had a porn addiction that I could not control. A long time ago, it was crazy. You know, at that time, there was no internet then. And I remember at 1 a.m, I would be walking out into the streets looking for a magazine stand to buy a pornographic magazine. I was uncontrollable. Yes, I was like an animal. It just, I could not. I needed my fix. Thanks be to God, God redeemed me. I've got good news for you. God redeemed me. God can redeem you too. Are you listening to what I'm saying? Number two, bad habit of temper. Say temper. You know, again. When somebody blows his stop, when somebody shouts, when somebody throws a ruckus and you know, shakes everybody up, you know, blows his temper, and then he calms down, and then he regrets what he says. Yes, 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 and then he will justify. He will give a little excuse. Sorry, yeah. Down. I have to say this in Tagalog. Ang baba ng tingin mo sa tao. People are made in the image and likeness of God. Do you know? No. You should say, sorry. Am I right? Sorry. Manok. Have you seen a cockfight? You know, chickens are not chickens. They're wild. They kill. They go on a rampage. Next, think about it. A person, a human being, was not designed by God for the bad habit of temper. What are we designed for? Ask me what? Book of Genesis, chapter 5. The fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, forbearance, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and so on. And then you have the bad habit of greed. Everybody say greed. When there's a greedy man in government, a greedy woman in government, massive suffering follows. Yes or no? When there is a greedy person in the family breaks up. Yes or no? I was talking to a woman, crying in front of me. She said, once upon a time, Brother Bo, our family, we loved each other. But then two of my brothers began to sue each other because of inheritance. Familiar story? And she told me this. She said, Brother Bo, once upon a time, our family met around in the dining room. Today, we meet in the courtroom. That's all where we meet. That's what happens when you have a greedy person. Where do you find greed? Where do you find, you know, when people are greedy, it comes from fear. It always comes from fear. And out of that fear, it becomes greedy. It becomes selfish. Then he becomes cruel. I'm not kidding. Now, where do you find cruel? I've been looking at, studying about this. This is, I have to ask your forbearance as I share these little research I did. Wasps, when they're born, will already kill their siblings a few seconds after they are born. You know, get hatched from their eggs, and they look at their siblings, and they'll start killing them. Why? Survival. Survival. The praying mantis. The female praying mantis. Maybe you read about this. This was all over the internet. It's wild. 30% of the time, when in the act of mating, will decapitate its partner. And then it will eat its head. Why? In case she gets pregnant, she will have nourishment and protein. Now, you might think, poor guy. You said, yeah, poor guy. Well, at least, he doesn't have to think of dinner after their date. It just becomes dinner. The black widow, same thing. The black widow, the most venomous spider in North America, does the same thing, eats its partner. But not only that, eats her children also. Out of 900 children, 200 people left. And you might say, oh, Brother Mo, that's only for insects. No, animals too. Rabbits. I took care of rabbits when I was a kid. They were my pets. And one of the things I noticed was they were very, very clean. But researchers have found out that sometimes, for an unknown reason, a rabbit will clean its house. Hamsters are cute and cuddly, and we make them into pets, but they're more cannibalistic than many other animals. What they do is they space eating their children. They have 7 children. On week 1, they will eat 1 child. On the 2nd week, they'll eat another child. On the 3rd week, they'll eat another child. Oh, Junior, come here. Oh, you're gaining weight. Let's go. Cruelty there. But God designed us not to be cruel. You might say, Brother Mo, you know, this is so repulsive. Stop telling those stories. Really? Repulsive? What are we doing when we gossip against people and we become judgmental and we condemn and we accuse? What do we do when we divide our groups because of our pride? What do we do when we don't think of other people? My dear friends, what do? We are acting like animals. This is God's call to be human again. This is God's call. St. Irenaeus would say that. The glory of God is man fully alive. And then there's one more habit I want to share with you. The bad habit of apathy. Everybody say apathy. I'll read a scripture for you. Jesus spoke about this. He said, once upon a time, there was a rich man, I'm reading from Luke 16, who was dressed in purple and fine linen and lived in luxury every day. At his gate was laid a beggar named Lazarus, barley to eat, but fell from the rich man's table. Even the dogs came and licked his sores. You know what's problematic about this story? Ask me what? The rich man? Did he slap Lazarus, the beggar? Did he hit him with a stick? Did he drive him out? You can't stay here in my doorway. Shoo, shoo, get out. Did he do that? No, the problem was not what he did. The problem was helping. The problem was what he didn't do. He just let him stay there by his door. Speaking about the offspring named Jesus. He's gonna crush